business somewhere down here, we would suggest that you look at it, try to find an alternate route. Obviously, leave early because traffic is going to be congested. Right now, all traffic is being rerouted at Razorback and at Hill, but this could go on for several hours.
Did you know the name of the people that were injured?
I'm trying to get that right now. Hopefully, I'll have that for you at my next update, and again, with any type of update on their injuries.
And just to clarify, the woman in the truck was transported to the hospital. Mm-hmm. The three people in the plane were also transported?
Well, I don't know if all three were transported, but I know that at least one person in the plane was transported. I don't know the exact number, but I'm trying to get that information from my next one.
Okay.
Did you know?
No, the parachute was on the plane itself. The people were still in the plane when it came down. The video that's out there that some of you have seen from some witnesses shows the plane being brought down by a parachute. The pilot deployed that parachute whenever he realized he was going to have a catastrophic failure in his oil in his engine because of the oil pressure. So he popped that chute, which brought the plane down a lot slower than without.
Do you have any idea of how long they were circling trying to land at Drake?
I don't. I don't know that they were necessarily circling. They were doing what they were called vectoring, which is trying to get a better approach, trying to get an approach angle for that. Because at one point, from what I understand, they were approximately 10 miles west of this location on their way to Waco. They were coming this way trying to get an angle of approach, and that's whenever they had to pop the chute.
Do we know the name of the hospital that they were transferred
again,
to?
I don't. I'm trying to find that out because, again, we do have several hospitals here based upon call. They may not have been able. Typically, a lot of them will go to Washington Regional. However, sometimes we do have to divert to other hospitals, but I will hopefully have that information for you.
Scott, you said that you guys were going to treat this as more of a traffic incident. Can you explain why?
Well, because, again, from the police perspective, again, this falls more to the FAA, NTSB, but since there was a vehicle collision there, we will investigate the vehicle collision aspect, but the FAA or NTSB will be the ones to determine, what caused the accident. So we're, at this point, holding the scene down until we hear from them as to what type of investigation they want to do.
You hear a call like this come across. How do you guys respond to something like that?
Again, it's just something that, never the same thing in a day. Again, it's the first time I can recall we've ever had a plane land on a major highway in the city of Fayetteville. You just handle it like you would any other scene, worried about the safety of the people in the plane and the vehicle, and then the safety of the people surrounding it, and then just try to work on, getting things back to normal as quick as we can.
Just to be clear, are you guys going to have this walk down until FAA until we get here?
Until we hear back from them, there is a possibility that they will allow us to clear the scene once we have documented. As you see, we have our traffic investigators out here taking very detailed measurements. It's very possible they could have us just go ahead and get the vehicle or the plane out of here. We've talked to one of the local wrecker companies, which thinks that they would be able to remove that vehicle, take it to a location for the NTSB and FAA to look at it once they get there. But again, right now we're waiting to hear back from them.
So where would the plane go?
That would be up to the NTSB or the FAA to make that determination. Most likely a hangar at an airport.
And the truck was towed away how long ago?
I'm sorry, what?
How long ago was the truck towed away?
The truck wasn't towed away. It was actually driven away by one of the officers. It was still functional.
Okay.
So we drove that away from the scene, again, trying to clear it out as much as we could.
Given the circumstances, how much worse could this have gone?
Well, I mean, considering the proximity of the school, the University of Arkansas, all the foot traffic out here, it could have been an absolute tragedy. Something like the parachute on the plane really saved this from being a lot worse than what it could have been.
How much longer do you think before you guys hear from FAA and they're actually on site?
I don't know. We're still in contact with them, talking back and forth, trying to get them as much information as they need to make that determination. They may send some people here to evaluate it briefly. But at this point, we are assisting them, holding the scene down. We're taking our own measurements for the accident report that we're going to have to complete.
Do we know the exact time of the
plane? I don't, but I'll have that for you at the next update.
And we don't know the three people that were in the plane, if it was a man, woman?
It was three males.
Okay. How old were they?
I don't know that yet. You got you.
Okay.
All right. Tell you what. Noon?
Noon.
Noon. By then I'll